Hello and welcome back. We stopped at declaring war on Burgundy. So I'm going to do something a little bit different now. I'm going to actually show you how I prepare for wars when I play offline. First I check my manpower pool and my total army size. So I have roughly 95,000 troops available for losing. Obviously I don't want to lose that much. That's the first thing I look at. And then I compare that to my enemies. And my enemy is only Burgundy, but it has a vassal and three personal unions. So all these lands, all these nations will contribute with their armies. And combined they have 19,000 for Burgundy. They have just let me sort this alphabetically. So, which are the ones? Brabant, Flanders, and Holland. Brabant has 9,000, Holland has. Flanders has 6. And what was the. Just a second. Holland, right. And Holland has 7. So, roughly 40,000 troops combined and Nevers. Now that's the first thing. So, and they can all dip into separate manpower pools, which is very, very dangerous. That's why wars against Burgundy can go wrong really quickly. Even for Austria, if it declares war on Burgundy and nobody joins her side, Burgundy can survive a lot of punishment in the early game. So my plan is to declare war for Barois and to yank out Nevers because it's a vassal, so Burgundy can integrate it faster. And I don't want them to be integrated, so I want to capture this province with minimal aggressive expansion because it's a core. And I want to punch out Nevers and Picardy, because it's not in the Holy Roman Empire. And the next war, if there will be one, I will punch out Flanders because it's also not in the HRE. So I can take it freely without, you know, worrying about demands for land and so on. So, first I check their army size, total army size. Then I check the generals. So you go into military, armies. I still have my god general is alive, so I hope he'll be alive for at least one or two more years, for this war at least. So let me see. Country, the best leaders of the world. So how can I sort this? There is no way I can sort this. Brabant 4-2, Holland 2-3. So that one is dangerous. But he's an admiral. Okay, so 2-1-2. Let's see. Burgundy. 1-3. So our general is. Wait, Nassau, that's not the one. It's usually much faster because there aren't so many nations involved. But in this one, we're 0-2. Okay, so. Our general is, I think, one of the best. Yeah. 4-4-1-3, he's one of the best generals. Scotland has 5-4-5-3, geez. That's really awesome. Unfortunately, they don't have such a strong an army. But unfortunately, Castile, although she owns me 17 favors, she is currently at war with Granada. So she is not going to be able to help me that fast. Maybe if that war finishes. And Poland still doesn't owe me enough favors, so only in 7 years I'll be able to call them in into any wars. And I'm planning on inviting them to a war against Aragon and Austria. So I hope I can do this war by myself. If it goes wrong, I'll try to peace out. If it's going mediocre, I'll try to just grab Barois and be done with it. It's low war score. And now the second thing I do after checking the, well, the third, after checking the armies and the leaders, I don't want to be in a war against like a five shock leader, you know, that's just crazy. I checked the forts. So, I know that these nations, wait a second, are in the war, so a bunch of nations. But now I, because they're all vassals or of the sort, so I need to check where can I stop him from reinforcing. That's the main thing. That's the main thing. So I need to check where are the forts. So one is in. So these two forts, and these two here. And Luxembourg said they got a bunch of forts. So my strategy cannot be to siege down provinces. I need to win war. This war will be a war score by battles. I can siege down the main province and the capital anywhere because it doesn't have a fort. But all these others are going. If I'm going to get more war score with them, I'll have to get it through battles. And for that reason, I have to first check, because sieging these many forts is impossible. They can reinforce in this region. Even if I carpet this here, I cannot hold Barua. I need to hold Barua with an army, because these two are forts. So, and I can't siege down that many forts safely with so many reinforcing troops, because they can buy a bunch of troops all the time, separate manpower pools. I can do. I'll explain later. I can cut their forces in a bit. But and what I need to do now, I forgot one thing. I'm pretty sure I forgot one thing to check. Right, military tech level 4. 4, 4, and 4, and my tech level is 5. So I have a tech level advantage, and it's not going away anytime soon. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to recruit another general, actually. I have 22 military tradition, and pray for the best. Wow, okay, 3 shock, that's really awesome for how crappy these leaders can be. So my plan is to kill these two armies immediately. That's the plan. And hopefully siege down Bourgogne, the capital, and Nevers, another capital, because, well, these can be held at least by some smaller force, while my main force will be in Barois and trying to, you know, damage, kill any armies that come this way. So, let's do it. I need all my troops in position as quickly as possible. Literally as quickly as possible. And it's time to start... start building a spy network immediately after my troops get into position. There we go. So... the first thing I do is declare war or reconquest. Wait, core return, liberation of vassals. Huh. Maybe this is actually better. Humiliate rival is maybe better. Because it requires me to take the capital, which I'm planning on doing anyway. So, but it's a lot of aggressive expansion as well. It's double than if I do a reconquest. Well, actually 4 times more. So I'm thinking rather, because if I take this, I can liberate these provinces for no diplomatic cost. But I think I'll take reconquest actually. I'm skeptical about me being able to get enough war score to yank out, you know, all do all my plans, and the diplomatic cost won't be that high. This makes sense if you like fight the Ottomans and you want to kick out, punch out, for example, Byzantium, or you attack Castile or Spain to punch out Aragon, because that's a nasty amount of diplomatic power required. But in this case, I think this will be enough. So, no time to lose. I'm going to declare immediately. I need 6 troops here. And 6 troops here. And then these guys will be the sieging stack. And these guys will move immediately north. Okay, okay. This is why this stack moved up here. So, slow it down a bit. I don't think these guys can come in time to save this army. But now I have to think what to do here, because this is like almost 30,000 troops. So I think what I'll do is just do this and bite the manpower loss. There we go. And now I can leave, what's this, 13,000 men. I can do it like this with my guard general, and this guy will reinforce, but I'll have this army to reinforce myself. Makes sense. Like so. Actually, I'll wait. Let's see what happens. Yep, good call that I waited. Oh, they're coming to Namur. They're rolling like crazy, but I still won big time. Okay, so I need a lot of troops to reinforce, so let's reconsolidate these armies. Let's see, I can split this army in half, and one can go here, and the other one can go here for now. They're surprisingly resilient, these troops. No stack wipes as of yet. I forgot to build a spy network here. And in the meantime, I guess I can improve, I don't know, relations with Castile. Maybe relations with Provence? No, they're full. Okay. Come on. And time to withdraw to Champagne. I need to oh, okay. So this is done. If they are going to stay there, I might try to risk it and like so, and try to kill this army once for all. But it might get reinforced, so that's why I'm bringing the other army as well. Unfortunately for them, I don't think it will be reinforced. So I can do this. Now, I don't want these guys to wander around, so I'll just tell them to attach to friendlies. I forgot about that. There we go. And a stack wipe. Okay, so I'm at 14% already, and Flanders is, and Burgundy's war exhaustion is pretty high. So now I have to dedicate one of these two stacks. How many troops do they have? Like 20,000 or so. So I need to dedicate one of these stacks to actually grab the capital. And I'll try to protect this area with this army here. Hopefully it should be enough. There it is, 15,000. I need to be very careful about what they're going to do. I don't want to lose too many troops. Still not enough troops. They're rebuilding the army, that's what's happening. Oh yeah, already at 30,000. So that's why it's so damn difficult to kill Burgundy at start of the... There we go. Decided to change course for Paris. 15, 13, 14,000 troops, it should be enough. Should be enough to punch them back to Burgundy. Except if some reinforcements come, which will be deadly. But I don't think these guys will come in time. Nope. Okay, so 5,000 troops, go. Okay, stack wipe, excellent. Reform the troops. So now they have, well, still very dangerous. I need one of these sieges to finish as soon as possible. Oh no, the king died. Yeah, sure. So, well, not bad. Lots of admin power for coring, that's for sure. Okay. Do I need some royal marriages? Yes, yes. Okay, but it can wait. I'm sitting here because it's a very high supply limit. And I can reinforce Barois if need be. bring these troops forward. I'm not going to risk. I will wait for them to come to Paris if need be. Come on, guys. You can do it. Siege down Nevers, please. Finally. Okay. So, 9,000 troops up there. Well, let's try and kill them. It is straight too far. Nope, they stopped. They might be waiting for reinforcements. Might be waiting for reinforcements. Although, it's tempting. Let's see what. Yep, was a bad call. And I rolled a zero, so... not good. Maybe I'll win in time, maybe. Maybe, okay. Wow, I must have rolled some crazy numbers up there. Like a zero. No, it's going great. Okay, this army is not needed up there. Fine. Let's group up in the moor. Bring these guys back. Actually, group up in the moor. All of you guys, group up here. And now we can dedicate a ...6k stack for that army there. Like so. Oh, he's coming my way. Well, no problem. Come on, don't roll zeros, please. There we go. Okay, and 7,000 troops up there. Do they have more? Yes, they do, but... how many do I need? Two more infantry. And the rest can move up this way. I would really like to get my general on the action, because it's way stronger than this one, but apparently it's not going to help. You know? Because it also has 3 siege, so very important. There we go, finally. Can put him to action. One unit too strong. Do I want to siege down anything else? No, I think this will be enough. Let's check it out. Oh yeah, stack wipe. Excellent. So, I don't know. How many troops do they have left? 20,000, and their war exhaustion is, well, pretty high. Do I have time to siege down another province? That's a good question. Yeah, I do. It's been only a year. And I'm still pretty high on manpower. I just lost 9,000 manpower total in this war. So this is what good preparation brings you. And good generals, of course. And being in Western tech. I guess I could try and siege down Rethel. I guess I could. That's only 6,000 troops, which will be put out of commission. Well, 7,000. This guy doesn't have any siege value, so I'll just leave them there. And I can always reinforce Rethel from Cambrai, for example. Okay, so we have an army here, which we could kill if we had enough troops. Okay, like 6,000. Let me see. Like so. Stay here. Group up. I need more infantry now. Yeah, that was a tactical mistake, didn't anticipate, but it's going to be fine. I'll just merge all these armies right here. Like so. Okay. This went well. Bring back troops home for faster reinforcement. And yet another lost battle for Burgundy. It's raking up really high war exhaustion right now. And now I'm in little danger of losing armies, so even without these two guys sieging. So I'll just sit here in Champagne and tell these guys to attach to these guys. That's a lot of troops. But I can stack wipe these guys, I think. Probably. Come on, go through Ottawa, please. Yep. And they have 18 troops. I'm not sure if I should attack this, but I'll... Oh, I can't. This fort is blocking me. Okay. I'll just stay here. And they made a typical mistake again. That's fine. They're splitting their armies up. Or maybe not. Let's get these guys like down here. They don't know what to do. They're stuck. Which is good news for me. What can I grab? That's a good question. Let's see. Wait, what? You got to be kidding. No, I forgot about that. Oh my god, idiot. And now I'm in a pretty complicated situation. Yeah. I should have checked that long ago. I could have had ticking war score by now. I need to stay here, that's the problem. Come on, guys, split up, please. To move, well, I don't need to move these guys. Yeah, this is good. This is good. Perfect, actually. Yeah, this is okay. Come on, guys. What can I get? I can grab... Barawa, that's for sure. What else can I get? Can I get them to cancel Nevers and to release Picardy? Almost. So that's the plan. Almost there. Maybe this war, maybe this fight, if it ends, I'll be able to grab that. Demanding without any forts in the area. So I need to siege down this fort. There is no other way around it. And this one as well, I think. Or maybe... Wait. Don't tell me I need to siege down Luxembourg. No, I don't need to siege down Luxembourg. Okay, so cancel subject. Where and release Picardy. Okay, but I need this fort to fall. Where is he going? Liège. So he's going for these guys. Okay. There we go. One more fort to fall and we are good. And he won't get there in time. Hopefully. Maybe he will. Come on, come on, you can do it. Ah, crap. Okay. Need to bring more troops. But this is the final fight, I think. Let's see if I can... Oh, we lost Beroa again. Stupid Luxembourg fort. You won't be able to afford it anymore. Hmm. This might result in a stack wipe, if I'm correct in assuming where he is going. So let's see. Maybe I'm right. Nope. Maybe. Nope. Come on, guys, you can do it. I need 13,000 troops here. Excellent. I'll get even more stuff out of him, I guess. And we roll zero. And another zero. And... yeah, whatever. Fine. Let's end the war. So that's okay. Well, that's quite a lot of points, actually. Might as well kick Flanders out as well. I don't think so, actually. Well, yeah, why not? While at it, why not? Also not in the HRE. There we go. And maybe war reps? Sure. Money? No. There we go. Wait. Much better. No war reps, eh? But some money. Okay. Bunch of points. But it's okay. These guys won't vassalize. Yep. These guys won't either. And these guys will also not vassalize because of base tax. And why are these so... Oh, we have cores. Okay, no problem. We can fabricate on them and kill them. It's not a problem. It's time to integrate Provence. And we can now use these spy points to fabricate some more on Burgundy. That's how we do it. So you use siege. You use the spy network for sieging, and later you just use that power to fabricate on your enemy. Oh. Only 25? Really? Oh, maybe. Okay. So, this war is over. I lost some 30,000 men, maybe 40. Still much more than he lost. He lost everything, literally. Wait, I should fabricate on Aragon now. Maybe Barcelona. Sure, why not? No longer a rival. Oh no. What will I do? Let me improve relations with... There we go. And let's start integrating the guy. 664 points. Because it's quite a lot of base tax, I reckon. Might wait for... I don't know, like influence ideas, but that's 1,200 points which I would have to wait for Provence to be integrated. I'm not sure if it's worth it, but let's see. In the meantime, how many favors? Only 5, so only 2 years passed. The war lasted for 2 years. Okay, I'll cut the video here and come back because the war is over.